Hello and welcome. My name is Manuel Quintana with Pragmatic Works, and in collaboration with MAQ Software, we're bringing you today's video to look at their custom visual called Data Insights. And of course, this is a visual with lots of different features and options, but it's really interesting because it has a real exploratory data analysis type of view here, where it gives users this capability of kind of twisting and turning the data to see it in different ways, to look at trends, patterns, look at detail level, maybe look at summary level. And it is definitely configured in a little bit different manner than we've seen in other visuals, but it's really neat, really intuitive. So come and join me as we explore the Data Insights custom visual by MAQ Software and Power BI. Okay, so here we can see the Data Insights visual by MAQ Software. And if we look well highlighted, we have the traditional field well. Now for us, we've input all these different fields, but we can see we're only visualizing certain items inside of a column chart. Well, the way we can go, if we look in the formatting area, there are some various options here, but there's one that sticks out specifically. You'll notice this presentation option. This is really where we can manipulate and we can get that more exploratory data analysis done here, where we can turn the presentation off, which will alter the visual in question and give us alternatives to what we're currently looking at. For instance, we can say how we want to view this, and we'll look at this in a little bit, but do we want to look at it as a brick chart? Bar chart, more tabular, so we can get the details of it in a table, and currently in the column chart. And for us in the column chart, you can see that we can control the X and the Y axis values either by using these drop-down options here or the options we can see on the left and then the bottom side of the visual. Also, we can dictate and control the colors themselves right in this drop-down, and naturally, of course, we can control the texts. The color by option actually would illustrate as if it was a legend. So if we wanted to, we could say color by month, and we're going to get the 12 different month breakdowns now within each of the columns. Do note that there is a nice undo button if you want to go back to where you were just in case, and that may be presented once you make any sort of change. But as I mentioned, we can go through and we can manipulate. For instance, if in this scenario we can see the profit for each of our cities, if someone wants to look at this by country, they can get that very easily. But what if we wanted to look at the breakdown, kind of bin this together? Well, we can go back to where we had it into city. We can say, I want to bin by country, so we can separate the cities into their various countries here. And then if we wanted, we could add another legend color by option at this tier. But we could go even further if we wanted to in this scenario. And we can do this by day, which is going to break this even more. And when we do that, you'll notice that we get a bin size option. So currently we're showing days 1 through 5, 6 through 10 in these 5 increment slots. That's going to be dictated by our bin size, which we can increase or decrease, and you can see our various bins are shown appropriately. So we can do this many different ways that we can analyze this. As well, something that we can see that isn't in the actual presentation options. So when you're set and you're ready, you want to go ahead and turn that presentation mode back to on, which will remove that element here. But then we do have the capability of turning on min, max, average, and constant lines. All we need to do is toggle the option on. The visual will reload with the respective line listed here for the averages, and we can choose how we should have this. Solid, what is the color, the opacity, and do we would like a data label or not? So with this, and the combination of being able to dictate what type of visual, whether we want to have something more summarized, such as the brick chart here, or do we want to have something that's a little more specific, such as what we're going to see just here in the grid area, which is just a literal breakdown, and we can choose which columns. Let's go city, country, and let's get their sales and profits. By doing this, of course, we get a more tabular view of the data here, but that's sometimes what we want when we want a more tabular, more granular view of the data. And if you want something more summarized, then you move over to something like the brick visual. All of this right at your fingertips inside of one single visual. That there is going to be our Data Insights from MAQ Software. So hopefully you enjoyed. And thank you for watching our video. If you have any questions about this visual or need a similar business solution, feel free to contact MAQ Software at sales@maqsoftware.com. As well, for any of your Power BI training needs, be sure to reach out to us at Pragmatic Works by emailing training@pragmaticworks.com. Take care.